speculation, all the leaks. E3 2018 is finally here. Thank God. We're getting all this great new gaming info. It's going to be a lot of fun. And you are now here for the Himmel God Has Spoken, episode number 8. It's the E3 special. Although it's only going to be me tonight. Thank you guys for joining me. I am Brian Himmelfarb, a.k.a. The Himmel God. Welcome for another episode here. Thank you guys for joining me, whether you're watching me here on Twitch or, of course, watching on YouTube. Either way, wherever you're watching, thank you guys for checking out this video. Greatly appreciate it. It's been a wild ride so far here on this show where things have been pretty up and down. And we've been getting pretty solid lately in terms of bringing content to the show. Usually I have games playing on the show, but unfortunately, lousy hotel internet says, nah, you can't stream. So I have to do it off my phone. I know, it's weird, but that's just how it is. It's the things I gotta live with to go ahead and do the show. But hey, thanks for being here. Thanks for hanging out. Let's get this show on the road because we got a lot to talk about in terms of E3 this year as it starts this Saturday with the EA press conference. Sunday, obviously, Microsoft and Bethesda press conferences. And then, of course, on Monday is like the big shebang. I mean, we're talking Square Enix, Ubisoft, and Sony all on stage. And, of course, on Tuesday, you get the Nintendo Direct. So it's a real busy time before we get to the part where all the games are in the convention center on Tuesday. So the lead-up, the build-up, which we've pretty much had for probably about the last couple of weeks, has been insane, but we're here now. We're here. Let's begin. Let's get underway. It's E3. I'm excited. It's Christmas time for us gamers. This is what we look forward to all year. And yet somehow it's becoming a little bit more irrelevant as the years go on because of all these leaks that are out there, mostly created by PR companies that like to say that someone else leaked info and they put it out on Reddit and whatever. It doesn't seem to be the case. It's pretty much PR. But anyway, let's get to everything before we get into the news itself and start breaking down these press conferences and what we can look forward to. We're going to cover the big three, Microsoft, Sony, and Nintendo. And after that, we'll get a little rapid fire going with third-party releases. So very entertaining. Let's get some shout-outs underway before we go ahead and get going here. By the way, Flowgrown OG, what's up? Flowgrown OG's in the house tonight. Thank you for joining me live. Shout out to the one and only Joe Cronin. Joe Cronin, you can follow on Twitter at Real Cronin. And of course, you can check him out on YouTube, Joe Cronin Show, which, by the way, has got through all the YouTube hurdles and all the problems. So I wouldn't be too surprised. Tomorrow night, Monetize This will be back on the Joe Cronin Show. 55,000 plus subs. Make sure you guys are subbed to Joe Cronin. We got Monetize This tomorrow. We got daily wrestling content. You're a big fan of WWE, you know where to be. It's at the Joe Cronin Show. And they do live reviews every Monday and Tuesday. You got Out of Nowhere on Wednesday. You got the Thursday Night Throwdown coming up later on tonight. And of course, Monetize This. And it should be absolutely insane from what I'm hearing. The wheel is back. And you know when the wheel is back, anything goes. It's going to be absolutely insane. So make sure you guys checking out the Joe Cronin Show. Also, shout out to the one and only Foulmouth Ken. Take care, Ken. They're over there at Ken Foulmouths over on the Twitter. And of course, Foulmouths Network on YouTube. You can catch live shows there. I think tonight he's doing a show with Billy Ricky. And then obviously you have Insomniac on Saturday night. You have Foulmouths Live. They had a great episode last night. It's every Wednesday. And of course, Foul Play every other Thursday with Lucky Low. Make sure you guys check out Foulmouth Ken. Also, shout out to the one and only Justin Bailey. You can follow him on Twitter, Justin Bailey IN. And of course, jbshow.net, where you get JB Radio. Lots of great content out there. Make sure you guys are checking out Justin Bailey. Also, shout out to the one and only Gatekeeper Drew. Make sure you guys are following him at Gatekeeper5150 over on Twitter, Derailed Gatekeeper on YouTube, where we have the Derailed podcast every Saturday night. which yours truly is also on. So you guys could get check us out. We got all sorts of topics, Cards Against Humanity. Anything can happen on that show. And by the way, I want to say big shout out to the one and only Ray Rock. Thank you, Ray Rock 421 over here on Twitch. Thank you, Ray Rock, for the follow. Greatly appreciate it, bro. Thank you for joining in here on the show tonight. Finally, of course, Billy Ricky. Got a shout out to one and only Billy Ricky. I'm going to bomb your show again probably on Saturday. I've been bombing his shows for the past few weeks, dropping Moabs. And I wouldn't be too surprised on the Insomniac warm-up show Saturday nights around 7 o'clock Eastern time, I drop another one. So you guys, sometimes you got to tune in early to catch the Moab drop. So when you do, it's pretty special. So make sure you guys follow Billy Ricky at BillyRicky03. Over on Twitter, and of course Billy Ricky on YouTube. He also, as I said, he does a show with Ken called Bill and Ken's Excellent Adventure. I think they got a new episode going on tonight, so make sure you guys check that out. While I'm at it with all this follow stuff, hey, if you guys haven't followed me on Twitter yet, what the fuck, man? We're getting close to 1,000 followers. It's just inching its way, you know, very slow. It got rid of a few bots, which I kind of did a Twitter audit just a few days ago, just to find out where things are going here on Twitter. Currently at 988 followers, we're 12 away. And I found out, according to my Twitter audit, I'm 98% authentic. 98% of authentic followers. That's awesome. You know, the other 2%, which was like 17, were bots. And you know how the bot shit works. It's pretty much they're there and they boost up your numbers, and then all of a sudden they just disappear again, and it's annoying as fuck. Because at one point I almost pretty much got to the 1,000 mark, and then all of a sudden it just dropped off. I'm like, what the hell happened? And only realized it was just a bunch of bot accounts, and I was like, oh, okay, you know, I don't want that shit. So, you know, no one wants a bunch of bots on their channel, you know, like Sean's View or whatever. But make sure you guys check out Twitter. We're getting close to that 1,000. I want to do a giveaway at 1,000. I really do. So tell your friends, tell your friends of friends, tell your friends of friends of friends, whatever it is. Send a couple follows my way over there on Twitter. Let's get to that 1,000. I just want to get over that hump already instead of keep mentioning it every single week. We're so close. We're so close. It's like there. You know, it's like the guy in the Geico, I was going to say YouTube, in the Geico commercial with the fishing rod. Oh, you almost had it. You almost had it. That's basically what it is right now. It's just like it's almost there, and we just need to get over the top. So we're almost at that mark. For any of you guys who are watching this episode on YouTube, which always goes up on YouTube after we go live on Twitch. So for those of you guys who are watching this the next day or anything like that, you know, you can also follow me over here on Twitch, which is the_Himmelgod. And you can actually watch these episodes live. You're going to definitely want to watch these live because that's where the most fun is, and that's when everyone's in the chat and we have a real good time in the process. Of course, for those of you guys on Twitch right now, of course, YouTube, youtube.com/buzzkillerb. That's where you find me over there. All these episodes, as I said, they go over to YouTube. And of course, I also have plenty of YouTube content, live Q&As, which I'm doing right now on Sundays. Everything that's going on with E3 right now, we're going to have live reactions to all press conferences this weekend. So everything's going to be live. I hope. If not, I'll do a sort of live stream like this on YouTube right after the press conference ends for each one. And then we'll go over them and talk about what was good, what was bad, and what was the cringe. We're really going to get into everything in terms of these press conferences. But if you're on YouTube and you do subscribe, greatly appreciate it. Click the bell while you're at it. Get the notifications. Let you know when I go live. So greatly appreciate all that stuff. Shout out, of course, to my subscribers here on Twitch, including the one and only Elias and also Johnny Ray Sinister, who have subbed here on Twitch. Greatly appreciate it. If you guys want to sub here, you can. Very simple. If you're a Twitch Prime user, you get it for free. You can subscribe for free. It doesn't get any better than free. Other than that, you know, you can subscribe to the channel if you want. That's greatly appreciated. It helps me out. Thank you if you choose to do that. If not, you want to just click the follow button, that's great. Just do that too, you know. Either way, it's a win-win situation. Like Ray Rock's done tonight, hitting that follow button. Greatly appreciate that. Also want to shout out the one and only Canadian Basement, who recently followed me over on YouTube. I had a lot of YouTube people hit me up in just the last couple days alone. So we're really gaining a lot of traction on YouTube. Thanks a lot, guys. Donations also live tonight if you choose. If you want to donate, it is your choice. You don't have to, but I feel like you got to mention it one time. It is there for your pleasure. You can do it through Streamlabs, obviously, which I kind of just put up in the chat for you guys. If you guys want to go ahead and do that, you can. And of course, also, bits are also available if you go into the chat. The bit icon is there. We're looking for the first bit dropper. Who's going to be the first one? Who's going to be the one to do it first? We're still waiting for that. We already got the first subscribers, but we're waiting for the first one. Drop some bits on the show. That's all, of course, it's all up to you. You don't have to do it. Of course, anything that is donated, either through a subscription or through bits, supports this show only. It doesn't go to the Joe Cronin Championship Fund. It doesn't go to putting someone else over for to monetize this championship. It doesn't go to my pocket directly. It is here to support the show so that I can do better things here for you. Giveaways also become a bigger option. We can make huge ass fucking giveaways here on this channel. Whatever you guys want to do, the options are there. So if you guys want to donate, as I said, 100% goes to the channel. It's not for me. It's to help build the channel, but also grow everything within and do giveaways and stuff like that. It will be great. So enough fucking talking. Let's get right down to it. It's E3. We start this weekend, just like I mentioned, all the press conferences already. We're going to talk about what to expect. Are there any surprises left? Honestly, I don't even know if there are any surprises left. I mean, Sony at this point is already giving stuff away, and we're just days away from their press conference, and they just announced, Tetris game, Tetris Effect, which is based off from the creator of Luminous and Rez. So I thought that was pretty interesting, although it's Tetris. And then, of course, just today, they announced a release date for Days Gone. And we'll get into that stuff when we start talking about Sony, which will be not too far down the road here in this episode. But I want to get a couple other things out of the way. As we know, at E3, there's always a sale. Always want to talk about the sales. Always want to talk about the big discounts on everything. It's like, other than Black Friday, you get E3 when they just start putting everything on sale. Some of the discounts might not be as deep as what you would get for Black Friday, but still, they're pretty damn good. So I thought I would go ahead and go into these first before we get into the press conferences themselves. Because right now, the Microsoft sale is going on starting today. It has already begun. It's already underway. Let me tell you guys what's in the Microsoft sale going on right now. If you haven't bought any consoles yet, here's your chance if you want to buy one. $199 for the 500-gigabyte Xbox One S console. That is available. What's up, Elias? Thank you for joining me, buddy. Also, $249 for the 1-terabyte Xbox One S bundles. I have seen some of these bundles in stores. Some of them come with PUBG. Some of them might come at Forza Horizon 3 or maybe Sea of Thieves or something like that. They're starting to put out these bundles, and we're going to see a few more of these now that with the sale going on right now for E3. Also, a discount, they dropped the price of the Xbox One X console, limited time only though, to $449, which is, I would have thought they would have went deeper on this, and unfortunately they didn't. I expected it to be $400. I think that would have been the best way to go. And you're going to see why in a few minutes when I talk about the Sony sale. But $449 for the Xbox One X right now. Also, up to 75% off select games including Far Cry 5, Monster Hunter World, Sea of Thieves, PUBG, Assassin's Creed Origins, Forza Motorsport 7, a lot of recent releases here, and so much more, including Xbox 360 games, backwards compatible games that are all getting these really deep discounts because it's E3. And who knows, maybe some of these games that they go ahead and announce especially if we get into terms of backwards compatibility, might be some of those games that are on sale. What's up, Broken Hardy's Goat? Thank you for being here calling for the Himmel Champ. also, 1 month of Xbox Live Gold and or Xbox Game Pass for only $1. Not bad of a deal, but we're only talking about 1 month. That's kind of weird, but of course you can still buy by the year and all the other stuff. Xbox Game Pass, it's worth it. If you haven't joined up yet, even for your first month, you would probably get it for free. And after that, they would charge you that $1 for a month kind of thing. Also, $10 off all controllers, at least as far as I know. These might just be the regular controllers, not the Elite, not the other type of controller they introduced. But it is $10 off all controllers. So, you know, they're going to be doing this big sale. It just started today for Microsoft. So if you're trying to get some stuff for your Xbox and you want to get more controllers, or you want to get, another month of Xbox Live Gold or something like that, you're looking to finally get some of those newer games that have just been released this year, but you've been waiting because maybe you couldn't afford them right away, or you didn't want to pay $59.99. Here's your chance right now to be able to do that at a little bit of a lower price. So I thought that was pretty cool. So as I said, Microsoft sale already underway. So that's not the only sale, of course, that is going on. We also have the Sony Days of Play sale, which is currently going on, or actually not going on. It doesn't start till tomorrow. First day of it is tomorrow. And let me go ahead and start out with the PS4 Pro console is going to be $349. Now, remember when I mentioned how the Xbox One X is going to be $449? This is why they should have brought it down to $400, because here comes Sony and says, well, hey, I got something for you. Here's $349. So now Sony still has that $100 advantage with the PS4 Pro. So this was a big deal for them to go ahead and get it at a lower price. So this was really smart. PlayStation VR bundles are going to start at $199. That's a big deal if you're still looking to get into VR. I don't think VR has been that big of a thing for Sony. It has sold well, but it hasn't really hit on the level that it needs to be. So 2 million, I think, in terms of overall sales. VR might be a bit on the downslide. You don't hear as much about VR all the time. Sony is trying to pump it out. They are supporting it, but we just haven't seen as much lately in terms of VR, even though at E3, I think we will see a bit of VR games get announced. But bundles starting at $199. Obviously, I'm pretty sure these might center around if you want to get Skyrim on VR, if you want to get the Doom VR game, or whatever other games, maybe like Until Dawn, Rush of Blood, or something like that, Battlezone, whatever, you know, whatever game you can get your hands on. You'll find those bundles for $199. DualShock 4 controllers are now $20 off. You can get them for $39.99. Great price if you're looking to get some controllers. Also, PlayStation Move controllers are now $20 off. They're going to drop down to $79.99. Not too big on the PlayStation Move, to be honest with you. PS4 Slim. If you guys have seen that PS4 Slim that's in navy blue and it has the symbols engraved on it, they're going to have that finally available. It's still going to be $299. Now, this is basically kind of the same type of thing they did last year that Sony did with the golden PS4. These are the slim consoles. They did that last year. It worked out very well for them, and now we're seeing it in a navy blue. So that's going to be for $299. Doesn't really come with any games, but I'm pretty sure they might pack some stuff in there for you to get started. PlayStation Plus, whatever it is. Speaking of PlayStation Plus, $10 off PlayStation Plus 1 year subscriptions. You can get that for $10 off. So you're looking to get your PlayStation Plus subscription. Maybe it's due. Here's a chance to go ahead and get it. Also, sale prices on all games, including God of War, Gran Turismo Sport, Horizon Zero Dawn, MLB The Show 2018, Shadow of the Colossus, and obviously a lot more. I'm sure tomorrow on the PlayStation Store, for those of you guys that buy digital, I do also buy digital, you're going to see these games as a digital sale, and you're going to probably see a shit ton more of games that are going to go on sale for PlayStation. So plenty there for the days of play sale. I don't know how long it's going to go on. It'll probably go through the early part of next week or something like that. It almost feel like a flash sale kind of thing. I thought there was going to be a sale with the headsets, but it doesn't look this to be the case on that. I didn't see anything on headsets, but then again, I could be wrong. Keep an eye out for that if you want to get the gold or platinum headsets from Sony. They might have that on sale. So there's just an idea on some sales. I haven't heard anything in terms of Nintendo doing sales, but usually Nintendo's usually not a company that you see a lot of stuff get discounted a lot or put on sale that much. So Nintendo might just stand pat and say, hey, we're not gonna put shit on sale. Here's what it is. You want the game, spend $60. Or hey, if you got a Best Buy Gamers Club unlocked, you get it for $48. Whatever. Either way, it's a win-win. I still got mine until 2021, thank God. So a lot of sales going on. They're going to be in all retailers as well as digital on the online stores for both Microsoft and Sony. So obviously big sales there going on. You guys are definitely going to want to check it out. For those of you that are hardcore gamers looking to get some of the newer games that you might not have bought yet, here's your chance. Okay, sales out of the way. You came for the good stuff. Let's talk press conferences. This is what we've been waiting for. The main event of the show. Get to the press conferences, Brian. I want to talk about those. I want to get the juicy information. All right? I want to know what's going to happen with Microsoft. I want to know what's going to happen with Sony. I want to know what's going to happen in that Nintendo Direct. What third-party games am I going to see? All right? This is really the meat of what we're going to be talking about today. And of course, for those of you guys who are in the chat and you're just joining in, you're a big gamer and you want to talk games right here, here's your chance. Make sure you guys let it be known in the chat, or hey, send a donation. You can, of course, derail the show. Derailed. We have that show on Saturdays anyway. But you basically can go ahead and hijack the show. Let me know what you guys are looking for. Let it be known in the chat. Throw some hype out there, because we're going to be talking about all sorts of stuff. So let's get to it. Let's start out with Microsoft, obviously. I'm not going to get into the third-party conferences like EA and whatever. That'll be that rapid-fire third-party section towards the end of the show. We're going to start out with our first of our big three, Microsoft. They're going to be up on Sunday, June 10th, 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific. They just about have the stage to themselves. Really, EA is the one that's going to have the stage to themselves on Saturday, because they'll have EA Play going on through the weekend. But Microsoft is going to have that first go like they always do. They're pretty much going to have, as a major hardware retailer, or manufacturer, sorry, not retailer, but manufacturer, they're going to have that first dibs to get people to talk a lot about Microsoft, of course, before Sony shows up on Monday. So they'll get that full 24 hours. And let's admit it, you know, some of us may not give a shit about Microsoft right now. They did announce recently that they're doubling down on games as a service, but you can bet your ass everyone's going to be watching the Microsoft press conference. And here's the reason why. Look, the pressure's on for Microsoft. It is. It's big time. They got to deliver, I mean, freaking megaton fucking bombs. They have to drop megaton bombs on this thing. They have to blow everybody away. Their press conference right now is shrouded in secrecy. Nobody knows what they're going to show, okay? Other than your Halo Gears Forza stuff. Everything else is whatever. We don't know. It's a big question mark. But let's face it, a lot of gamers are looking at this maybe saying, this is do or die for Microsoft. This is it. We know about EA putting out those numbers about how many consoles have been sold. This is no secret. They estimated less than 30 million. You know, PlayStation right now is moving itself closer to 80 million. So Microsoft really realizes that you've had games that have releases that have been less than stellar, especially in your exclusive lineup with games like Sea of Thieves, and then of course State of Decay 2. Hell, you can even throw PUBG in the mix, you know, because it's pretty crappy on the Xbox. But this is do or die. This is it. It's either you're going to come strong or you're buried. It's the end of the road. It's the end of the rope. Phil Spencer, you had 4 years. What do you got for us? There's no more excuses anymore. Yes, Scalebound was canceled. And we're going to talk about Crackdown in a few seconds. But it's not looking good in terms of Microsoft. But is there a chance that they could turn things around and have a stellar E3 press conference? Sure, it's possible. But let's get into this because consumer confidence is at an all-time low at Microsoft. They need a pick-me-up. As I said, Megaton bombs, Reggie Jackson home run numbers of the World Series. They need to come out big. This is it. Bottom of the ninth, two outs. What are you going to do? This is what we're going with. So let's open up with the most obvious one here. Let's start with Crackdown 3. Word has been out now for, I think, since yesterday that Crackdown 3 has been officially delayed once again. It's been delayed to 2019. Could be an early 2019, like a January or February release is very possible with this game. I still expect some sort of multiplayer-based trailer. If you remember that a few years ago, they showed a multiplayer-based trailer with full-on fucking destruction. Okay? Now, of course, if you're playing the single-player portion of the game, you're not really going to get anything really truly destructive in terms of buildings falling and all sorts of other stuff. You're not really going to get that. The multiplayer is really where that angle is going to be with the cloud gaming. But we're expecting a multiplayer based trailer on this one. What's up, TSS? Thank you for joining me, brother. So multiplayer based, destructible environments. We probably will get some story elements with this, which could help. Now, let's face facts. You can't just come out there and peddle Terry Crews at us, okay? Terry Crews on a screen will not be enough to save this game right now. If you show off a half-assed generic shooter, which is what looks like what Crackdown is looking like right now, that shit ain't gonna work. All right, fans are gonna be pissed. You're gonna probably hear some boos. We don't want that. You can throw up all the fireworks or whatever, you know, when they did this a couple of years ago. We're not having it, okay? We want to see the game. We understand now that it is delayed till 2019. Give us something. Give us something to hang our hats on. Don't give us a generic half-ass game. It's not going to work. Crackdown 2 was garbage. All right? It's a garbage game. If they announced it on backwards compatibility, I probably wouldn't even care. That's how much I wouldn't care about the game. Even the first game's kind of like that. And I mostly got the first game just to go play the Halo 3 demo. So there you go. But nothing half-assed. Show us something to get excited about. Don't just stick to Terry Crews on a screen to get us excited about a game. So Crackdown 3, we will see it. But as we all know, delayed till 2019. It has been delayed again, as in the last couple of days. All right, Halo. Let's get into Halo. I expect to see some sort of Halo presence at E3. This is Xbox's flagship title. So this is really where it's going to be. I think you're going to get a good chunk of Halo in this press conference. Okay? The possibility of a Halo 6 teaser could arrive at the end of the show as a, oh, and one more thing moment. That's what we're probably going to see towards the end of the show. Lights go down, and then all of a sudden, you hear Cortana, and then eventually hear Master Chief, and then we get it right there, a logo on a screen for Halo 6. This will get people hyped, get them excited. Hopefully everything was a good press conference till that point, and that way it pretty much can save the show a little bit more for them to show Halo 6. So very important, get a teaser out there. You don't have to show gameplay or nothing. Just get us hyped. That's all you have to do. I do expect to hear more about the Master Chief Collection. It's a game that has had a lot of problems, especially for those who would play multiplayer. This was an issue. I do expect to hear more on that, including a 4K update, which they did talk a little bit about on Inside Xbox, the last previous episode of Inside Xbox. They have talked about that. So we're going to hear about the 4K update. We're probably going to see the game in 4K. You're going to get to see the whole action of all the games in terms of single player, and even part of the multiplayer, even though I think the multiplayer might probably won't run at 1080p. But also, I expect some sort of enhancement to the backwards compatible Halo Reach. So I expect Xbox One X enhanced for that game. Or, here's your or right in this one. What if, kind of like how Halo 3 ODST was added to the Master Chief Collection, we get Halo Reach as well? And maybe they make it a free download. Free download of Halo Reach. Everybody go get Halo Reach. Very strong possibility, I think, that this could happen. So if we don't get the enhanced mode on for the backwards compatible version, give us a 4K Halo Reach, which I consider one of the best in a series, because it was the last one that Bungie did before handing off the baton to 343. So going on with more Halo here, there have been some rumors about a Battle Royale mode for Halo, whether they would put it into Halo 5, which has been rumored, but I don't think that's going to happen. Look, Battle Royale is more of a fad, and I don't want to see more of Battle Royale. I'm getting it with Call of Duty this year. There's been some rumors that Battlefield was going to have a Battle Royale mode. You know, we can always stick some game and say Battle Royale mode. Forza Horizon, Battle Royale, you know, or, you know, Castle Crashers, Battle Royale, or whatever. We don't want to see that. So I don't think a lot of fans would be happy. Don't chase the fads. We don't want a Battle Royale, even with Halo. Even though it might sound really interesting, I kind of don't want it. So hopefully that does not happen. Also, rumors have been making their way around the internet about something called Halo Infinity. I've been hearing this name now for the past couple of days. I don't know much information on this right now, but this rumor is starting to gain steam. Where this goes, who knows? But there has been rumors about this, and I don't know what it's going to be. This could even be the Battle Royale game, for crying out loud. We don't know what it is, but the information is starting to trickle in, drip in very slowly, although Microsoft's conference is on Sunday. We might be hearing a little bit more about this Halo Infinity in the coming days, obviously, maybe even on Sunday this could happen. So there's pretty much what I would see with Halo. I don't think they'll announce anything anymore of Halo TV or anything of that stuff. We're just sticking with games. I don't think they're going to do that in terms of a Halo TV series. I know they did a little bit with Locke and no one gave a shit. But it would have been cool to see a Halo TV series with Master Chief. I ain't gonna lie. Or maybe had a group of Spartans. I think that would have been really cool, especially with Steven Spielberg behind the helm or something like that. I think it would have been really cool. But let's move on. Gears of War. Obviously, we're going Halo Gears Forza, folks. Here we go. So Gears of War, I expect to have see at E3. As we know, Walmart Canada has leaked a placeholder for Gears of War 5. It was on their website. It's recently been taken off. But the rumors started to circulate. It's like, oh, finally, Gears of War 5. It's going to be awesome. Although we haven't really seen anything of the game. Like, nothing. Remember, they built up Gears of War 4 before they put it out. But we haven't seen any build-up of Gears of War 5 and think, well, here it comes. We're going to release it in March of 2019. You know, I don't think that's going to happen. But if it is true, we will see a gameplay trailer with a release window in 2019. If that's the case. So we'll get maybe that little bit of a buildup of Gears of War. Rumors have also been circulating about more than one Gears of War game. We've heard up to three Gears of War games could be revealed here at E3. But I don't think it's going to be three. I mean, maybe just two or something like that. But rumors have been circulating about a Gears of War real-time strategy game similar to Halo Wars 2. Now, if you've played Halo Wars 2, I haven't played Halo Wars 2 because I'm not a real-time strategy player. I kind of don't really care about a Halo Wars 2. You know, I'd rather just play the main game. But now we're seeing this, the possibility that this is going to happen with Gears of War. The idea is that this game will take place sometime after Emergence Day, and where you'll be able to face off against Locust Forces, you know, again, as you're members of the COG. And of course, it would probably have a multiplayer where you have COG forces and Locust and whatnot. Sounds cool, but honestly, as I said, I'm not big into real-time strategy. Now, this rumor has been gaining a lot of steam lately, especially in the last week. And this may, in fact, be legitimate. So chances are, say, if we don't hear about Gears of War 5, you're probably going to hear about this Gears of War real-time strategy game, which might frankly piss you off. But it's not what I really want to hear, but it looks like that may be the case. Moving on here to Forza Horizon 4. Again, no surprise, Forza is a yearly release, but it is a given that Forza will once again make his yearly appearance at E3, along with showcasing a car that nobody can afford. No surprise to anyone there. They're just going to do this. They'll showcase. They'll probably just come up on a stage out of nowhere. Here's your car, everybody, that we'll put on the front cover. And then here's your gameplay. Rumors are that the game is expected to take place in either Japan or the UK. The UK one more, the Japan more actually, we'll start with Japan. The Japan setting was something that was there early on. And it looks like now the UK one's been building up steam a little bit because supposedly in a file, they were able to find a lot of like Aston Martins and stuff like that. A lot of more UK-based car manufacturers and vehicles that seems to kind of dictate that this game will take place in the UK. I was kind of a little bit more excited to say if it was Japan. I think that would have been really cool. But UK, either wise, I'm all right with it if you want to do something in London and whatnot. Gameplay trailer, obviously, we're going to see gameplay of it. I don't think it'll be much of CGI. You're going to see full gameplay. And we expect a release date at some point this fall, or maybe as early as maybe late August or into somewhere in October. I think that's where you're going to see the release of Forza Horizon 4. So overall, I'm excited about the game because I am a guy that loves racing games. However, we're milking that teat of Forza a little too much. Okay, Forza Horizon 3, great game. I absolutely loved it. I loved the Hot Wheels expansion. I thought it was great, and I'd love to see what they're going to do next. However, like, you're milking the teat way too much, dude. Too much Forza. Microsoft, although it has, I think, officially signed Playground Games as one of their developers, so obviously maybe they have more in hand than just Forza, and then we get to see something else from them other than racing cars. So this, I think, will be very interesting as we move on down the road with Forza. Moving into another one, another game here, Fable 4. This is one is very early in development. It was announced not too long ago that they were working on a new Fable game. I expect some sort of teaser announcement. No gameplay, just a teaser announcement that Fable 4 is being worked on. And development of the game is being handled by the Coalition. The Coalition, as you know, they do Gears of War. So now we're going to see another team work on a Fable game. No release info will be given. I don't expect that at all. As I said, just a teaser announcement. Nothing more, nothing less in terms of Fable. Next up on my list, Ori and the Will of the Wisps. As you know, Microsoft, they are big with the freaking indie games. Ori and the Blind Forest was a huge success for them. Cuphead, which just finally released late last year, has done very well for them as well. So they've been doing good in terms of exclusive indie games. And now we're finally going to get the sequel. Now, last year at E3, Microsoft announced the sequel to Ori and the Blind Forest. We got to see a little bit of Ori and the Will of the Wisps. And I expect a full gameplay trailer of the Metroidvania game with a release in 2019. I don't think we're going to see it this year. I think this is a game we're probably going to see early in 2019. So I'd love to see it come out this year because of the lack of exclusives, especially in the late point of the year for Microsoft. And now having no Crackdown 3, you know, Ori is going to have to lead the charge into 2019. Ori and the Blind Forest, great game. Looking forward to seeing what they do with the sequel. I'm going to throw a wild card at you guys. And either this is going to happen or it's not. And you always got to throw a wild card out there somewhere and just kind of shock people. Let's remember, Microsoft, we don't really know what they're going to have at their press conference. It's a blank slate. Anything can happen. And I believe this is that one game that will happen. And I'm talking about Perfect Dark. All right. There have been plenty of rumors circulating on the internet about a return or perhaps a reboot of one of Rare's most popular games. All right. These rumors currently state the new title, which might be called Joanna Dark, a third-person action slash shooter, possibly some stealth elements within this game. Now, remember, we haven't seen a Perfect Dark game since 2005's Perfect Dark Zero, which was not that great. So the track record's not looking too good right now. But they need to take advantage of these Rare properties. If this game is true, and it turns out to be a hit, I don't think we'll see this game till 2019. But if it turns out to be a hit, then the potential exists for now Microsoft to say, hey, let's work on some of these other Rare properties that we have. Talking about Banjo-Kazooie. Maybe we could get that taste of nuts and bolts out of our freaking head because that game was terrible. All right. And then, of course, the return of our beloved Conker. Because some of us want to see a sequel to Conker's Bad Fur Day. Yes, that game was released a long time ago. But I still believe that this has the possibility to return once again. So hopefully we get to see a sequel to Conker's Bad Fur Day if the Joanna Dark game hopefully works out. So there's Microsoft in a nutshell. Oh, there are some other tidbits that we may expect here in this conference. I expect them to announce a new Xbox Elite controller. This has been rumored now for a little while, and I expect to see it at the press conference. We're going to get the Elite controller version 2. That will be announced. At least 15 backwards compatible games will also be announced at this press conference. Fans in attendance love their backwards compatible games. They might cheer for that louder than anything else that happens in this whole event. So, at least 15 backwards compatible games will be announced throughout this press conference. If you go back to Inside Xbox a couple episodes, I think it was episode 2, they announced 19. Especially because you had the original Xbox games. But I say 15, I think it's going to be a combination of 360 as well as original Xbox games will be announced. Mortal Kombat maybe? I'm hoping so. Could be some Mortal Kombat announced as part of that backwards compatibility. Minecraft. No surprise here. Minecraft will be on stage once again. Use it as your bathroom break or go make a fucking sandwich. Because I'm pretty sure most of us don't care about Minecraft. Honestly, we just don't. You want to spend 6-7 minutes up on stage talking about Minecraft? I don't care. Go ahead. Because I have literally no interest. Most of the kids these days probably aren't playing Minecraft as much. They're playing Fortnite. Just saying. But you want to talk about Minecraft? Go ahead. I mean, last year they announced Minecraft in 4K. Like any of us really cared. At least 85%. of this conference will be focused on indies. I saw that, Elias. Kids. At least 85% of this conference will be focused on indies and third-party games. Should that be a shock to anybody? I mean, that's pretty obvious. Microsoft has a lack of exclusives compared to Sony and Nintendo, where they can focus a little bit more on the exclusives and less on the third party. Microsoft has to focus on games, especially marketing. A lot of that stuff they got to really get into, which I'm going to get into my next point on that. But also, indies has been a big focus for them, ID at Xbox. So we'll see a lot of indie focus in this press conference. So focus on Red Dead Redemption 2 release. We're going to be getting a Red Dead Redemption. TSS says, I like Minecraft, but the game should be a 10-second thing, or a percentage should be no more than 2 minutes. Yeah, good luck on that one, TSS, because they're going to bring that chick out on the stage that did last year and said, super duper, and we're going to see that shit again. But seriously, just go take a bathroom break, go make a sandwich, do whatever you got to do, and then by the time you come back, it'll be over. Hell, my nephew used to be into Fortnite, and you know what he plays now? He plays Minecraft. He's into Fortnite. My other nephew, he used to play a shit ton of Minecraft. He's playing Fortnite now. They're all playing Fortnite. They rarely even touch anything that has to do with Minecraft anymore. But that's the case there. Tidbit here to expect, Microsoft will continue to hammer down on Xbox Game Pass for all exclusives, as well as some third-party games, where they have marketing rights for day one. This might not be a good thing for some of those third-party companies that have marketing deals with Microsoft, because Microsoft's going to want to put those games on Game Pass, where people pay only $10 a month as day one. So I'm expecting that to happen. You're going to hear a lot of announcements about that. Xbox One exclusive and Game Pass. You know, that kind of thing. Or they might say Xbox launch exclusive with Game Pass. You're going to see a lot of Game Pass hammered into everybody's throats. But listen, Game Pass is a great service. It really is. And it's worth, you know, checking out if you don't have it yet. If you're on Xbox and you haven't checked out Game Pass, check it out. I mean, I think it's pretty good to give you a good selection of not just current Xbox games, but also with the 360 and the original Xbox as well. All that for $10 a month, like a Netflix style of service. So that would be cool. Mr. Merez? Naruba Man Russian Bear is in here. Oh, nice. Really cool. Elias says they need to focus on Sea of Thieves. Also, Microsoft dropped the ball on it. Hell yeah, they dropped the ball. They did a Megalodon DLC, which is now available for the game. So you might want to definitely go ahead and maybe check that out. But yeah, they've kind of had a lack of content. So that's really been an issue. So you would definitely going to want to look into seeing. They need more content. State of Decay, it needs a lot of patches. I think it would State of Decay, if they can patch it up just right, it'd actually be a pretty fucking good game. Just saying, I'm throwing it out there. But they got a lot of work to do. And when you look at Crackdown, it's probably another reason why they delayed it, because if you made a if you brought that out now, half-assed and kind of, you know, style of game, it would kill Microsoft. So that's why they're delaying it again to 2019. They got to polish the shit out of that game and make sure it works, especially in the multiplayer. But that's pretty much Microsoft. And they got to hit megaton bombs. They got to hit home runs over and over and over. It's a two-hour press conference, although lately I think I've heard they've narrowed it down to an hour and 40 minutes. That's still close enough to 2 hours. But listen, a lot of people are going to be watching. Either they're going to be watching to see if Microsoft fails, or maybe they get a little bit more excited and maybe want to at least buy an Xbox One X, which is on sale right now, or get an S or something like that. You know, maybe there's some interest there, and maybe they can have at least a tad of hope to get people to buy, even though, let's face it, I think Sony's probably going to end up blowing them out of the water, but because we're going to get into Sony right now. So if you notice now, when I did Microsoft, I only focused on the exclusives. I didn't get into the third-party stuff. Third-party, I'm going to talk about a little rapid fire towards the end. So for those of you mentioning Red Dead Redemption and all that stuff, you know, we're going to get into it. So if you got a game that you're really interested in and that you really want to hear about, make sure you guys are putting it in the chat or send it through a donation, whatever, if you want to hijack the show a little bit. So, Sony. Monday night, June 11th, 9 p.m. Eastern Time, 6 p.m. Pacific, is going to be the Sony press conference. As we know, it's not your typical press conference. Sony has been dishing out to the fans everything you can expect at this year's event. So my question is there any surprises left? I mean, they've basically given away everything. Today, as I said, they announced the release date for Days Gone, February 22nd, 2019. So we already know when Days Gone, another exclusive, will make it on shelves. They also announced Tetris Effect. So, yeah, screw Raw. Check out the Sony conference, says Elias. Hell yeah, man, I'm telling you. Don't even watch Monday Night Raw. Just watch Sony, dude, like everyone else is going to do. Forget Raw. You know, and I'm just telling you. But Sony has already stated. Now, they've stated this. I'm not going to go too much into it. But they've already stated that they will take what we call those deep dives into four big exclusives. Spider-Man, The Last of Us Part 2, Ghost of Tsushima, and Kojima's Death Stranding. We're going to see gameplay. We're going to see insight on everything, especially Death Stranding, because I really want to know more about that game. I'm already excited about Ghost of Tsushima. I'm really psyched about that. Feudal Japan, samurais, ninjas. Fuck yeah, dude. I'm in with that game. Sucker Punch, it's almost like they can't do wrong. You know, The Last of Us Part 2, we know what Naughty Dog is capable of, and I'm really psyched for it. And of course, Spider-Man, I already got that game pre-ordered, ready to go. I got the collector's edition ready. And sadly, I'll be on the road when that game is sent to my house. So I'm going to have to wait till after I come home to go ahead and play it, but do a full unboxing and everything. It'll be awesome when I finally get a chance to play Spider-Man, which probably won't be till November. God, that's going to break my heart. But still, I'm psyched for it. And we're going to see more gameplay from each of these games. So there's a lot to look forward to. When it comes to what Sony is going to do, what they're going to bring to the table. So, are there any surprises left with Sony? And the answer simply is yes. I still think they're holding out. Hopefully they don't reveal it during these next couple of days. But let's face it, they might. But hopefully they leave it for the press conference. So here's one of those games. Bloodborne 2. Bloodborne 2. Have you guys been watching Twitter lately? I'm telling you, pay attention, because here we go. Back at last year's Game Awards, a 30-second teaser appeared from Japanese developer From Software. You also know those guys from Dark Souls, all right? And, of course, the original Bloodborne. But anyway, the words on the trailer featured "Shadows die twice," okay? Now, rumors have been speculating that this could be the teaser to Bloodborne 2, all right? Or it is a brand new IP that is set in ancient Japan. Keep that in mind right now. Now, also recently noticed on Bloodborne's official Twitter account is counting down the days until Sony's press conference. Coincidence much? Does it sound like we're finally going to see Bloodborne 2? Because it tells it to me. It looks pretty fucking obvious. All right? When I'm sitting there watching you count down a number each day leading to that press conference, it tells me that this is Bloodborne 2. All right? It's not going to be some new IP, although they mentioned a new IP called Shadows Die Twice, but I doubt that that's what it's going to be. I think this is Bloodborne 2. I don't think we'll see a release for it this year. Probably won't be until 2019. But it's something to get excited about because I'm down for freaking more Bloodborne. Love the first game. Still play the first game. And I want more. So Bloodborne 2, I think, will be an announcement on Monday's show. Next up, Shenmue 3. All right. Now, back in E3 2015, the official reveal of Shenmue 3 via Kickstarter appeared, and within one day they met their goal. Greg from Connecticut, what's up, man? What's the best tasting cheesecake in Wisconsin? I don't know. If I want a cheesecake, I go to or cheesesteak. I kind of want to go to Philly. Just saying. But yeah, they reached the goal for Kickstarter within a day. Since then, radio silence, folks. Canadian Basement, what's up, buddy? Good to have you here. Great to see you. It's been radio silence with Shenmue 3. Now, with HD remasters of Shenmue 1 and 2, which are expected this year, okay, I'm thinking that once they kind of show that, you got cake on the brain. I know, yeah, cheesecake, yeah. Don't get me started, man. If I start eating fucking desserts, I'll get all fucking fat. I don't want to fucking do that. Shit. But with the Shenmue 1 and 2, HD remasters are going to be out this year. They've already announced that during a Sega event in Japan. So Shenmue 3 footage could follow those HD remasters. Like, they could have a trailer showing the remasters, and then all of a sudden, you start to see Shenmue 3 footage. I don't think we'll see this game until around 2019, 2020 at the latest, like an early 2020 game. But we will see Shenmue at this show. So I'm psyched for it because I want to see Shenmue. I'm a big fan of it. And if you think about which Shenmue probably helped lead into what we have today in Yakuza. So this is going to be really cool. Very exciting moment. Got to take a drink once in a while. But we're definitely going to see Shenmue. And I want to see how the game is progressing. Show me a little bit more of the remasters and get me psyched because it's hard for me not to be too psyched about fucking Shenmue at this point. But I do believe we will see it at Sony's press event. All right. Another game that was revealed at the 2017 PlayStation Experience was Medieval. All right. It trailer appeared and pretty much was just like words on the screen. Medieval. We now know it's coming. This appears to be a remaster of the 1998 game from the original PlayStation. Now, rumors are also circulating that this remaster will include both Medieval and Medieval 2, sort of like how they did the Crash Bandicoot trilogy and the upcoming Spyro trilogy. We're going to see something like that. So they're going to give us more Medieval. And if sales do well, they'll probably work on another Medieval game. I expect this to be released this year. I think we will see it maybe towards the latter part of the summer or into the fall. We'll see Medieval make its release. So it's not that hard to port over a game, but still, I think they'll make a lot of HD enhancements, as I said, like Crash and like Spyro. They're going to do that. And really looking forward to seeing what they're going to do with Medieval. All right. Most of the show has already been given away. Here's a wild card for you guys. I don't know if this is going to happen, but rumors have been flying about this. Some have been debunked, but still some rumors are flying about backwards compatibility. There has been some reports that are starting to gain a little steam about backwards compatibility on PS4, especially with PlayStation 3 games. The rumor may have been debunked a bit on a couple of occasions, but lately you guys might have seen a screenshot of TSS. I see that there. We'll talk about that in a second. There's a screenshot. It looks like it comes from the PlayStation 4 store with the words Best of PS3 at the top. Hopefully this is real, but again, long shot here, okay? There was someone who had like a paper showing everything that was going to be on the press conference. It had the PlayStation logo and it had E3 on the bottom. Let's face it, anybody can do something like that. And they said, play PS2 and PS3 games on your PS4. Well, you kind of already can play PS2 games because they have them in a digital store, which, you know, Sony likes to, you know, drip a game once in a blue moon. You would think they put out more. PS2 is one of their best-selling consoles. You would think they'd give us a lot more games, but they haven't. But it looks like this backwards compatibility thing is gaining steam. So whether it's just going to be digital games in a store, or maybe they allow you to put the disc in and play it, which, again, I think is a long shot, it could happen. So this is a very strong possibility. As I said, big fucking long shot here. I don't know if that's going to happen. TSS bringing up Just Cause 4. This seems to be a possibility. However, they've also mentioned that the creators of Just Cause have a different game in mind that they've also announced officially. So I don't have that on my list, but I did read the news about that earlier today. Other tidbits to expect from Sony's press conference. As we know, if you were in certain cities, the Sony press conference will be shown on movie theater screens in certain cities throughout the country, or even some areas around the world, for free. So you might want to check out and see if tickets are still available, or if you go, maybe you might want to bring some deodorant for somebody who probably didn't take a shower in a few days. That'll probably be there to go watch the Sony press conference. Help someone out, right? You know, help someone, help another, that kind of thing. But it is in movie theaters, so obviously there's still something big that they're not revealing yet, Bloodborne 2. But and maybe the backwards compatibility thing, and they get fans really excited instead of just watching a live stream. So obviously something is up in terms of Sony. Will Media Molecule's game Dreams make another appearance? Dreams has been very quiet. Again, radio silence. Where is Dreams? They really pushed the shit out of this game for a bit, and then it always disappears. We never see it anymore. Where is Dreams? There is a chance that we probably do see it on Monday. More PlayStation VR games will be announced. I'm not talking about games with the optional VR part. I'm talking VR-only games. I'm going to put this number at less than 7. I don't think you'll see any more than 7, but I think we will see more VR games, which they'll probably show in either a montage or a couple of trailers here and there, but they will show VR. PUBG will finally be announced for PlayStation 4. Another game to get excited about. We knew PUBG was going to show up. Microsoft had the timed exclusivity for a while, and now we're finally going to see the announcement. PUBG coming to PlayStation 4. Now, this might break some people's hearts. No hardware announcements, so give your hopes up on PS5. You will not see anything that has to do with PlayStation 5 at this conference at all. Sean Layden has already stated that, so I'm going to restate it again. No hardware announcements will be shown here, so don't ask. Remasters. Obviously, there's still a chance we see a few other remasters. So other than the Medieval announcement, I'm going to say less than five remastered games will be announced at Sony's press conference. I'm going to put the number at less than five. No more than that. I know a lot of us are sick of remasters, but let's face it, they're probably going to do it anyway. And if this backwards compatibility is not a thing, obviously you'll see some more remastered games. Like I mentioned earlier, Days Gone announced was earlier today with a release date of February 22nd, 2019. Tetris Effect also previously announced. It is VR compatible. And as we said, each day leading up to the E3 conference, they're releasing something else. Supposedly an unannounced game will be tomorrow's event for PlayStation when they do like a 20-minute thing that they did. They've been doing for the last couple of days. They'll talk about a new game. Supposedly it's an unannounced title is what we're going to see tomorrow. All right. Where's my Nintendo people? Here we go. Nintendo Direct. Tuesday, June 12th, 12 p.m. Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, we will get Nintendo Direct. Usually this is around a half an hour, maybe no more than 45 minutes, somewhere around there. Usually these things are pretty short. However, not only they're short, but they're filled with so much stuff. So Nintendo will once again stream a Direct event during E3. Larger focus, obviously, on the Nintendo Switch. Less focus on the 3DS. Expect more information, obviously, about their online service, which is going to start this fall, which leads into the first game I'm going to go ahead and talk about, which is Super Smash Bros. Right off the bat, let's just get right to it. This is going to be the main focus of Nintendo's Direct, is Super Smash Bros. This is their big game. This is the one everyone's been looking for. It will be the central focus. This game will not be a straight-up port of the Wii U game at all. This is going to be an all-new game. We will get at least a dozen characters being revealed during this event. I know I'm probably being a little overzealous, but let's be honest. I think we will see at least a dozen characters revealed and four new stages. Dozen characters, four new stages. Also, possible guest character may also appear during this Nintendo Direct, during Smash Brothers. We might see a guest character. Will it be like a Banjo-Kazooie? Possible. Could it be like a Joanna Dark? Possible. And maybe they do something with Microsoft to bring a character into play. Maybe Crash Bandicoot makes his appearance. There's definitely got to be a guest character. Especially because you're going to have the you got the Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy also coming to the Switch. Nintendo will tie in their online service along with this game. So they're going to really hammer down the online functionality. They're really going to get into the whole thing about this on Super Smash Bros. Expect an official release date in 2018, and also something with amiibos. Obviously, amiibos will be a factor here with Smash Brothers. So make sure you guys check that out because it's gonna be a lot of fun. I can't wait to talk a lot about Smash Brothers. Next up I got on my list is Bayonetta 3. Bayonetta 1 and 2 already available for the Switch. So we can expect a brand new gameplay trailer for Bayonetta 3. Now not much is known about the game. We already know it's like a stylish hack and slash action game. No surprise there. But I'm expecting a release not this year, but in 2019. Platinum Games, you got to figure, they're a studio that never disappoints when it comes to games. It's very rare that they would disappoint you with a game. Scalebound. No, Scalebound got canceled, so I can't go there. But we're definitely going to see something, you know, from Bayonetta 3 here during this Nintendo Direct. It could be something very short. It could just be a trailer. It may be something that lasts maybe for a minute and a half or 2 minute focus, but give you something to get excited about. And Bayonetta 3 is going to be that game. They're going to get you really pumped, other than Super Smash Brothers. Or my next game I'm going to bring up, Metroid Prime 4. Last year we had that teaser announcement, Metroid Prime 4, now in development. We've had a year. What's been happening with Metroid Prime 4? Okay, we know that Metroid's alive and well. We're going to see something really awesome. And once again, we will get a teaser trailer. Something that'll last maybe a minute. But in that minute, they give you some freaking goodness that's going to be awesome. Well, at least I really hope that will be something special. So I do see a release possibly in late 2019. Now, I don't think we're done with Metroid. I think that there's a possibility that they announce some type of remaster with the older Metroid games. So I think that there's a possibility that we would see Metroid Primes 1, 2, and 3. Very strong possibility that this will happen, that they will probably announce it during their Nintendo Direct. I think there's also a Yoshi game that's supposed to come out. I didn't really mention it, but I think there's a Yoshi game on the way, and I'm pretty sure they will focus on that during the press event as well. So expect to see that. And I think there's probably a Kirby game, maybe another Kirby game. But let's get to the wild card in this mix. Chances are, again, this may not show up on the Direct. It may show up somewhere else. I'm talking about the N64 Classic. Things have been very, very quiet about the N64 Classic. We haven't heard anything about it. It has been radio fucking silence. But I could tell you this. If it gets revealed during the Nintendo Direct, expect the internet to fucking break. I'm telling you right now. The internet will break if Nintendo chooses to announce the N64 Classic during their Direct. This is my wild card right now. Usually it's not known to announce during a Direct, but in a separate trailer, especially during E3 week. They did that with the NES Classic and the SNES Classic. But I think the N64 Classic could be announced during this Direct. Now, I think that this will come with 20 games, kind of like how the SNES Classic was, including Mario 64, The Legend of Zelda's Ocarina of Time, and Majora's Mask, Mario Kart 64, Star Fox 64, Super Smash Bros., as well as a good amount of other games, with a release date in November of this year. If you think about it, 2 years ago, we got the NES Classic. Last year, we got the SNES Classic. Now we're going to get the N64. Although it probably will stop there. I don't see a GameCube one coming. But this is what we've been waiting for. Hopefully, maybe even they put Rogue Squadron on this motherfucker. Because I love the Star Wars games. Maybe they give us a Star Wars game. Again, reaching. But still, possibility. Other game I didn't mention during this is that there's another Star Fox game on the way. Supposedly, this is going to be a Star Fox racing game. I don't know if a lot of people are going to care about that. But there you go. Chances are, again, another Star Fox game. Although, probably not the Star Fox that we want. But there you go. Nintendo's Direct. I'm pretty sure there's a few other games I didn't mention. But those are the ones I think that are going to get the most attention during the Nintendo Direct. All right, finally, let's get into third party. This is going to be a rapid fire third party because let's face it, there's a lot of third party games. We got third party press conferences. EA, obviously, on Saturday. Bethesda on Sunday night. And then, of course, Monday before E3, we get Square Enix and Ubisoft. There's Devolver Digital. There's the PC show, for those of you guys who are in PC. So there's a lot, really, to get into. And there's a lot of games we're going to be talking about here in this third-party segment. I'm not going to focus on every single one of them, but some that are interesting nonetheless. So I take another swig here. Feel a little bit better. So, let's hammer our way home with these third-party games. Rapid fire, here we go. Kingdom Hearts 3, let's open it up with this one. We are finally going to get a release date with Kingdom Hearts 3. This will happen. I believe that the possible release will happen between October and December of this year. They already had a Kingdom Hearts 3 premiere event. It went over very well. And now we're expecting a full-on release. This will be revealed at either Square's, Enix's, or Sony's press conference. I expect it at the Square Enix conference more than Sony. However, the Sony conference could throw a trailer out there. Hey, Kingdom Hearts 3, here you go. Now, let me throw this out there that may disappoint some people, but honestly, it's probably for the better. No Marvel or Star Wars worlds or characters will be in this game. Do not expect any Star Wars. It's too big of a universe. Marvel, again, too big of a universe. Yeah, it's coming up in the Wreck-It Ralph movie, but we're not going to see it in Kingdom Hearts 3. Won't happen. The Marvel thing could be possible because, you know, there is a Marvel game being worked on published through Square Enix and Crystal Dynamics. So there you go. There's another one, the Avengers project. We should be hearing about during Microsoft's press conference. But Kingdom Hearts 3, as I said, through either Square or Sony's conference. Even the Marvel game, the Avengers game, could be announced at Square. I think Square will probably have a big focus on it, but Microsoft probably will as well. Anthem. Remember this game from last year? So Anthem will be revealed at EA as well as Microsoft's press conferences. We're going to get a new gameplay trailer focusing in on story as well as the co-op multiplayer, with a release expected in 2019. Now, originally it was partly slated to come out this year, but I think it's going to move into next year. So here we go. Thing I'm worried about when it comes to Anthem is microtransactions. EA, we know you for microtransactions. You fucked up Battlefront 2, and we're not going to deal with the bullshit no more. So please, no freaking microtransactions to go with this game. Battlefield 5, another game I'm worried about in terms of microtransactions. This will mainly be on stage at EA, and eventually they'll show it at Microsoft. A heavy focus will be placed on multiplayer. If you remember in the EA conferences for the last couple of years, they had a multiplayer section during their streams, in which they showed one of the years was Battlefield 1, and then the next year they did Battlefront 2. We're going to see that with Battlefield 5. This year during EA's conference, and then on Microsoft's conference, maybe they focus a little bit on the story, because I think EA wants to focus more on the multiplayer as well as customization. And please, for the love of fucking God, do not bring up freaking microtransactions at all, because it would piss me off. No, Wesley, I'm not going to sing. Fallout 76, this is one that's been revealed earlier this week. Still no word on what this game really is. Rumors are circulating that this is an online survival RPG, possibly with some base building. So I'm worried that this doesn't become Fallout Shelter 2.0. This will be revealed at the Bethesda press conference. They're going to spend some good quality time on this Fallout game. So looking forward to seeing what it is, but I'm a little worried. I don't want this to be a strictly online game, but I have a feeling that's the focus of where we're heading with this one. Call of Duty Black Ops 4. Sony's press conference will focus on this one, especially in terms of the multiplayer, and more information we'll find out about Blackout, which is the Battle Royale mode. We didn't get much of that during their official reveal, but I think at Sony's event, we're going to see a lot more of the multiplayer and Battle Royale. For those of you that are looking for zombies, because I'm a zombies player, I love to play zombies in my Call of Duty. So Jason Blundell, later in that week, probably around Tuesday, Wednesday, they're going to have a panel where they will be talking about zombies. So we'll get that later on. This is also going to kind of ring into the point of a season pass for Call of Duty. So if you haven't pre-ordered it yet and you want to get it, chances are you might want to get the deluxe edition, like a digital deluxe or or a regular deluxe edition, or they might have like a deluxe edition plus or something like that, which really kind of gets into Comic-Con and whatever when they talk even more about zombies, because I have put out there that the rumor is there's probably going to be a fourth zombies map, which is strictly probably going to be Nuketown. That'll come as a pre-order bonus. So this kind of brings the season pass and everything into play, camos and all that other stuff that we expect with Call of Duty. Resident Evil 2 Remake has been making its waves around lately. We've heard this even towards last year's E3, but once again, we're seeing this again. Capcom may reveal the game at the Sony press conference, maybe even Microsoft, it could be one or the other, but we're going to see the Resident Evil 2 Remake. All right, game will be over-the-shoulder view, sort of like what Resident Evil 4 was, and survival horror and puzzles will still be intact. Don't expect the game this year. I think this will be a 2019 game, maybe an early 2019 game, or maybe closer to the summer of 2019. We could see the Resident Evil 2 Remake, maybe even late, but I know it's going to be in 2019. It won't be this year. Final Fantasy VII Remake. Again, the possibility is endless here. Very quiet. We have not heard much on this since the PlayStation Experience a couple years ago. But we might see some new gameplay, a trailer there at the Square Enix press conference. I don't think we'll see this at Sony. I think it's going to be at Square where they're going to show the Final Fantasy VII Remake. As we know, Sony does have the exclusive rights in terms of a timed release ahead of Microsoft. And we know that this is going to be episodic. I know it's not the words a lot of people want to hear, but that's what we got. Devil May Cry 5. This was revealed at Sony. Will be revealed at Sony's press conference. I don't think it'll be at Microsoft. This will be at Sony. Again, not much known. We're gonna get the original Dante back at least. We're not gonna have emo Dante like we had in DMC. This is gonna be the Dante that we all know and love. Expect release in 2019. I'm pretty sure they've been well underway in terms of development. I don't think we'll see it this year, but I think this is something that we're gonna see next year. Shadow of the Tomb Raider. Gameplay trailer will be at Microsoft's press conference. I wouldn't be too surprised if this game opens their show. I've said this quite a few times to people. I think Shadow of the Tomb Raider opens Microsoft's press conference. We're going to get a full-on gameplay demo. All right, we've seen trailers already, but now we want the demo. We want to see the game in action because this is not being done by Crystal Dynamics, so we need that confidence that I think this is Eidos Montreal that is working on the game to bring us the Tomb Raider experience that we all want. So I do have the game pre-ordered. I did get the Lara Croft edition. So I went all the way with this one for the $90. It will be out this fall. I think it's in September. So TSS saying Xbox needs to find a way to revive Scalebound. I agree. maybe they come out there with Scalebound t-shirts. Who knows? And get the speculation to begin. But yeah, they need to bring back Scalebound some way, somehow. I definitely agree with you. But yeah, Shadow of the Tomb Raider full demo. Splinter Cell. We know about Splinter Cell is coming. We're going to see a gameplay trailer probably at Microsoft's press conference. And at Ubisoft's conference, I think we're going to get more out of Splinter Cell, including maybe a gameplay demo. Release expected in 2019. That's where I see Splinter Cell. Starfield. This is a game that's been talked about last year for Bethesda. And now this year, it looks like this is when it's going to happen. Starfield, which is basically a sci-fi RPG, will be revealed at Bethesda's press conference on Sunday. Not much really known about this game. It's, again, shrouded in secrecy. What is it? We don't know. It's very interesting to me. If it's on the level of, say, the Elder Scrolls 6, Elder Scrolls 6, there's another game we'll talk about another time. But if it's on the level of Elder Scrolls and Fallout with a sci-fi theme that could take place in space, call me interested. I'm down for it to see Starfield, so hopefully that happens. Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater Remaster. This one's been thrown around a bit. This could be revealed at any of the press conferences of Sony, Microsoft. More than likely, we might see this on Nintendo. I would not be too surprised on a Nintendo Direct. They announced Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater Remaster. This one is gaining a lot of steam in terms of the rumor mill. You look at the Xbox One backwards compatibility, and they only put out Peace Walker game. Where's Metal Gear Solid 2 and 3? I really believe this is a full-on remaster that we're going to get, which is considered one of the best Metal Gear games, period. So, really excited about this. And so this could be revealed at any of the press conferences. I think we'll see a release date this year. So, mark your calendars for that. Metal Gear Solid 3, this year. Assassin's Creed Odyssey. I thought that maybe Ubisoft would take a little bit of a break with Assassin's Creed. Not the case here. We're going to get a new Assassin's Creed game that takes place in ancient Greece. This could center around like the Homer's novels of the Iliad and the Odyssey. That would be very interesting to get those iconic characters that we've grown to love through history. Like your Agamemnon or your Achilles, Hector, Helen of Troy. All this stuff could be in this game taking place in ancient Greece. So this is a very interesting game to look at. I don't know if this is going to, how it's going to happen, what it's going to take place. Kind of shitty deal to say, hey, let's bring Assassin's Creed back so quickly and go back to yearly releases. No, come on. Every other year would have been better. Drew, what's up, man? Gatekeeper Drew's in the house. Make sure you guys are following Drew. He is here today. And make sure you guys follow him at Gatekeeper5150, the Derailed Podcast. Make sure you guys check that out on Saturday. Big shout out to Drew. Thank you. Look at this sexy mofo on screen. Damn right. Might be this Packer shirt I'm wearing. Who knows? Respawn Entertainment, the guys behind Titanfall, will probably show some sort of teaser trailer or teaser announcement to their new Star Wars game. This will be revealed at EA's press conference on Saturday. Not much. Again, knowing about this game, we've been hearing maybe like an action-adventure game with some RPG. Obviously, single player. I didn't hear really anything about a multiplayer focus, which kind of makes me wonder why they canceled Visceral Star Wars game. But release expected in 2019 or 2020. It's still very early in the development cycle for this new Star Wars game. So, oh man, you're waiting for bedtime for the kid. Oh, there you go. Hey. Understand there, Drew. Thanks, though, for being here. Borderlands 3. Let's talk about it. Walmart Canada leaked Borderlands 3. Gearbox has come out. Randy Pitchford has said, we will not have Borderlands 3 at E3 this year. But Walmart Canada, they revealed everything, and they've been 100% true so far. Everything has been true. So we have to see Borderlands 3. Maybe, Pitchford could be trolling us like a certain other troll that we know on Twitter that we'll talk about very shortly, Ed Boon. But rumor is that it won't be there, although possibly, more than likely, probably will. And then we also know about a Borderlands remaster of the original game will be there. And say they do the Borderlands remaster and say towards the end of the trailer, like I mentioned about Shenmue earlier, that we will have this bit of a teaser of Borderlands 3. So I think he's trolling us. This will be at Microsoft's press conference because Microsoft does have the marketing rights for Borderlands. Yeah, I talked about Shenmue earlier, Drew. You missed out. Shenmue 3 will be at Sony's press conference. There you go. A little more of a reminder. It will be there, and I'll also show the remaster of the first and second game. So expect to see Shenmue 3. It will be there. Okay, so speaking of internet trolling, let's get to Ed Boon. Mortal Kombat 11. We need our fucking Mortal Kombat game. And we're waiting and waiting and waiting. Today, I sat there and they announced a WB Games reveal. And I sat there and said, oh, dude, here it is. Mortal Kombat 11. We're finally getting it. And then they show Hitman 2. Why did I waste my time watching that shit? I did not care about Hitman 2. Listen, if some of you guys here do, that's fine. That's your prerogative. But for me, I can probably give two shits about Hitman 2. But Mortal Kombat 11, I think this will be revealed at either Microsoft or Sony's press conference. I would not be too surprised if it's Microsoft's. Release expected in early 2019, probably no later than April. The gear system will probably be back that we've seen from Injustice 2 will be here in Mortal Kombat as well. Maybe to get those classic costumes and stuff like that from the characters that we've known throughout the series. It will continue the story from after in Mortal Kombat 10, where the bad guy could be Raiden. Could be Liu Kang and Katana being the evil characters, telling them not to invade the realms. So very interesting if you look back at the ending of Mortal Kombat 10, especially in, when you look at Raiden, because somehow Raiden could be the bad guy in this game. So, Mortal Kombat 11, Ed Boon's not going to be able to troll this much longer. I think we're going to get our reveal. And this is where I find the more idealistic reveal would be during Microsoft's press conference to show Mortal Kombat, to get it in during the weekend, instead of waiting until Monday and show it during Sony. I think it'll be at Microsoft because they could tie in backwards compatibility with all their Mortal Kombat games. Why do you think I mentioned 15 backwards compatible games could be announced during their press conference? I think you're going to see a lot of Mortal Kombat. This is where we could get finally get Mortal Kombat 9, finally get the arcade collection that we've been begging for backwards compatibility. Why do you think I mentioned it earlier in the show? But also getting maybe those 3D Mortal Kombats. Also getting Shaolin Monks. Very distinct possibility because they can release a whole shit ton of Mortal Kombat backwards compatible games with this announcement. So I think this would make sense during Microsoft's E3 press conference. So Mortal Kombat 11, it's going to happen. It'll release in 2019. And I wouldn't be too surprised hearing a backwards compatibility announcement, especially at Microsoft's E3 conference. Red Dead Redemption 2. We all know this is coming. I got this pre-ordered. I got the Ultimate Edition already pre-ordered, ready to go. I can't wait to play Red Dead Redemption 2. It's one of my favorites. I love the first game. Hopefully they don't do an Undead Nightmare because I don't want to see that. But Red Dead Redemption 2, which I think is released in October this year, it would be revealed either through Microsoft or Sony's press conference. Wouldn't be too surprised, again, if this shows up on Microsoft stage. Very strong possibility, especially if you've noticed some of the marketing lately. Buy an Xbox One X, get Red Dead Redemption for free. Smell a little marketing right here, and that we could possibly see Red Dead Redemption 2 during Microsoft's event more than I would say Sony. However, look, Rockstar is such a big company. They don't even need the stage of Microsoft or Sony to show their game. They could just throw their own random trailer whenever they want to and say, here you go, Red Dead Redemption 2. So they don't really need to hype it up on someone's stage, but if they do, I think Microsoft's stage really fits here because of the advertising lately that we're seeing. Buy an Xbox One X, get Red Dead Redemption for free, the backwards compatible game. Soul Calibur 6. Will be probably at Microsoft's press conference, more than likely. Four new characters, I believe, will be revealed during this event. It feels like that this game is sort of rebooting to the first game, or the first Soul Calibur game, and not Soul Edge, which was out before that when you go back to the original PlayStation. 2018 release, for sure. I think that this game will be released towards like an August, September range. I think that we'll see this. I don't think this game will slip into 2019. It could slip a little bit later down the schedule, maybe making it towards November because you kind of don't want to release in October. That's Broketober, and you don't want to be there. But Soul Calibur 6, I'm thinking more September. Four new characters revealed at least during this event. But I do see it at Microsoft's press conference. Sony, possibly. Don't see it during Nintendo because I don't think they'll do that. Now, I got one more game to mention. Again, I'm going wild card here because this one's been radio silent now for 6 months. I'm going to take you back to 1993. Back in 1993, the arcade was buzzing. Mortal Kombat 2 was big during that time. But another game was tearing it up out there in the arcades back in the day where you might have heard a little phrase called Boom Shakalaka. I'm talking NBA fucking Jam. All right. Tim Kutzra, who is the voice of NBA Jam, was in talks with Microsoft back in January of this year. Talks went very, very well with them. This was brought into an ESPN interview back this past January where he talked about this, talked about we're making a game. It's been radio silence about anything NBA Jam since then. Now, EA owns the rights to NBA Jam. I expect at EA's press conference, hopefully not during an EA Sports segment, which is really the bathroom break of that press conference, they will announce NBA Jam. It's coming. It's real. It will happen. Mark my fucking words. It is the 25th anniversary of the game, and it's expected to be announced officially at EA's press conference. It will not be a Microsoft exclusive, because we mentioned talks with Microsoft. Microsoft's going to go the same route that they went with games like Minecraft and be able to pull it out on all platforms, but Microsoft's just going to get that money, okay? In other words, hey, you might buy it on PS4, but you're still buying a Microsoft product. That is how Microsoft's going to make that money. That's exactly what they're going to do, and NBA Jam will come back again. The only difference is, like, we had the On Fire edition back in 2011, 2012. The big difference that we're going to see here is that this game will probably receive yearly updates. They're going to make this thing into a service where they'll update the rosters so you don't have to keep buying this game at whatever price they want to charge, $20 a year or whatever. But we're going to see the old rosters and we're going to see new. So we might see those rosters from 25 years ago and then see the rosters of today. We throw a couple of players here and there, and we're going to get the NBA Jam we've always wanted. Now, let's face it, we're not going to probably not get Michael Jordan, although the possibility is there, but I don't think we'll see Michael Jordan. We probably will see Shaq or something like that, but then you got the Shaq Fu game that's out there, so who knows how that's going to work. But we'll definitely see all the great NBA players, maybe Dr. J and stuff like that. You know, I'm really looking forward to NBA Jam. I think this is real. It will happen. And by Saturday, mark my words, we'll probably see it. And hopefully it's not introduced by Jesse Wellens. Please don't bring Jesse Wellens back to E3. Remember that from last year? Hi, my name is Jesse. I'm a YouTube creator. I'm here to bring Need for Speed, Payback, and I'm a YouTube creator. Please, no more Jesse Wellens, for crying out loud. Nobody wants to see him. No one wants to see him with his back turned to the camera, turn around and be like, hey, I'm Jesse Wellens. Fuck you. Don't want to see you. Please stop bringing content creators to your shows or streamers to your shows. We don't want to see it. Put the guy who produced the game out there and fucking just go with it. There's my little rant there. I guarantee we'll see some cringe starting in that EA conference, and I will report those cringy ass fucking moments. Because I guarantee it's E3, you know it's bound to happen. Remember, guys, after each press conference, I will go live. I will go live on YouTube, so make sure you follow me on YouTube, youtube.com/buzzkillerb, after every single press conference, because I will go live probably for like a half hour, 45 minutes, maybe even an hour at the most, talk about that press conference, talk with you guys of what you thought about the press conference, get your opinions, tell me what you guys thought. So anyway, this is wrapping up the show here for today. I hope you guys enjoyed the E3 special that I brought to you. We're going to have a lot of fun this weekend going over all the press conferences, everything that happens. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure on the way out here, guys, if you're watching on YouTube, make sure you guys click that like button, click the bell, get those notifications, especially when I go live during the weekend. Very important. Make sure you guys go ahead and check that out. Those of you guys are on YouTube and you haven't been able to participate in the live Twitch, make sure you guys do that. It is the_Himmelgott. Now, eventually, the Himmelgott has spoken will move to YouTube, but it's on Twitch right now because, obviously, I can't stream any games. Hotel internet is just terrible. Can't do shit without the thing knocking off in like 1 minute. But make sure you guys still send the follow like Ray Rock did tonight. Greatly appreciate everyone who hits the follow button. Also on Twitter, as we get close to 1,000, I know I've been saying it a lot, but at some point we're going to get over the hump of 1,000 followers very, very soon. As I said, we're at 988 and we're going to grow. Thank you guys so much for anyone who's followed. Thank you for so much for anyone who subscribes, anyone who donates, anyone who does anything and just wants to hang out in the channel or hang out in the chat. We've seen quite a few people in the chat tonight. Thank you guys so much for being here. Anyway, let's get out of here. Let's have a great night, everyone. I am Brian Himmelfarb, aka The Himmel God. Hopefully you guys enjoyed tonight's E3 special. Give me some games in the comment section for those of you guys watching on YouTube. Let me know what game you want to see. And we'll see you guys this weekend. It's going to be a lot of fun. Let's have fun for E3 and get excited for gaming once again. Thank you guys for being here. I'll see y'all next time.